Hey guys, Laura coming back at you. I think I'm losing my voice a little bit. I've been talking all day long. Not that that's a stretch for me. We are coming to you from Omni Hotel out here in Nashville, Tennessee. And I am joined by Shane Owens. And how are you?
I'm doing great.
I was
just
going to keep rolling on about.
Hey, if you lose your voice today's a good. You got a good excuse for it today. Interviewing all us artists, and we appreciate what you're doing. Absolutely.
No, I love it. And we were just trying to. We were trying to remember and reminiscing about how long it's been since you and I've actually talked, and it's been 2 years, two CRSs ago. I think that's proper grammar, isn't it?
Two CRSs ago.
It can at least be country grammar, can't
that's
it?
That's country grammar.
Two CRSs ago, that's when we first talked. and I was honored to be able to review your album. And there were so many, like 19, my brain just went blank. 19 really stuck with me, too, but... you have so many great songs on that album.
Yeah, we've had the opportunity to write with some of the biggest songwriters in Nashville, and I'm a writer as well, but we got to work with one of my heroes on that project, Randy Travis, and he executive produced that record. Mm-hmm. So, that record was special, and I appreciate you saying that, but we had a lot of good songs on that record. This new EP is they're even better.
Are they?
Yeah.
Well, and... Going back real quick, talking about Randy, the other thing I was just honored to do, and I'm not breaking any codes by saying this, was to get a review copy of the book, of the memoir. And I'm just, like, I was always a fan, but I can't wait for the world to be able to read this story about this amazing, amazing man, musician, artist, everything. So, and I mean, that has to be great for you that he produced the album.
And it is, anytime you can work with your hero, I mean, that don't happen every day.
Right,
Country Music Hall of Famer, one of the best male vocalists of my generation, of our generation, and to work with somebody like him and have him appreciate what I'm doing.
Yeah.
He's a hero of mine with so many other people like Haggard and Jones and Alan Jackson and George Strait. But Randy, he's a dear friend. And what he done for country music, he led the way for artists like me that are still trying to keep traditional country music alive.
You know, and one thing he says, and this brings me to some of your new stuff that I want to hear about, is he said when he was trying to get radio to play him, they said, you're too country.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems that some of radio is still saying that to some artists like you. You're too country.
They have, but things are changing. I see the pendulum swinging more back toward traditional country music.
Yes.
We see it in our live show every day. We see it. We see it at radio. We're seeing it here.
Yeah.
Today, so there's hope.
I think people are hungry for it.
They are.
I think they get a taste of some of it, and then they're like, well, and then if they go back and look at where some of that came from and some of that started it, they want more of that.
Yeah, well, the younger generation today is listening to Keith Whitley and Randy Travis records and Alan Jackson records.
Right.
They know who George Strait is.
And
Shane Owens records. Absolutely.
So tell us about the new stuff.
The new single's doing well. It's been out 2 weeks. We've already charted. I think we're sitting at number 59. It's called I'd Love to Try 'Em On.
And
the song is paying the respect and homage to our heroes like Merle Haggard, George Jones, and Randy that have paved the way for artists like me. Like I said, the title of it is I don't know if I could fill their shoes, but I'd love to try them on. You know what I mean?
Nobody will
ever take the place of what Randy and Haggard and Jones done for country music. We're just trying to keep it alive,
Yeah.
And that's what we intend on doing.
That's amazing. So is the new, is just the single out right now, or is the whole EP?
The EP's out, but what we did was we're going to let the single saturate good.
Okay.
We're going to ride it out, and then we're going to go in and cut a new album.
All right.
We've thought about doing the EP thing, but I really want to go out and put out 11 new songs.
Yeah.
And let the single buy some time. We want to thank people like you that believe and everybody at radio for playing the new single.
It's great. And you are just, in general, you're authentic and true to who, anytime we've had a conversation or I see you talking with other people, you're thankful for being able to stand here with us. But I'm thankful that you're willing to take the time to do it. So I think it becomes a two-way street. But we need artists like you,
to
continue to carry that torch, I appreciate it.
I thank my mom and dad for raising me the right way. You know, it's all about respect, and I think if we had a lot more people respecting one another and loving one another more in this world, it would be a better place to live.
Isn't that true? That is so true. Well, Shane, people can find you at Shane Owens.
ShaneOwensCountry.com.
Okay. You all make sure you check him out. I'll pull all the links up, and I'm probably even going to go ahead and pull that review so you all can see what I had to say about it from the last album, and I'll keep you up to date on stuff when the new stuff's coming out, and get out to see him and go buy what he's got available now. Shane, thank you so much for
Thank you so much.
Yeah, see y'all later.
See you later.